to watch this fight here. These guys can peg. These guys have talent.
Yeah.
They're undefeated. Harvin Aguirre with 8 wins, 0 defeats. And his opponent in Israel Lopez.
Here is Israel, the Destroyer Lopez. A very tough southpaw from Tipitapa, Nicaragua. 30 years of age. His last fight was in July of this year, winning by a knockout in the first round against Brian Munoz here in Nicaragua. Tipitapa, mi querido Jesse, he's just like 15 miles north of Managua. Very close, yeah.
Well, the fans are definitely cheering him on. Going up against the Nicaraguan, but now braced and resident of Panama. I wonder if the fans are gonna take him in just the same as they did Israel Lopez. Coming in with the sombrero. People cheering him on as well. That is Harvin Aguirre coming into the ring. Age of 23 years of age. Has 8 bouts, 6 by knockout. So this guy definitely packs a punch. Very technical. Likes to take his time. Has some nice solid shots. Loves to hit the body. I really like this kid. I think that he has tons of talent.
He was born here in Nicaragua. Then he moved to Panama. He's been fighting in Panama most of his fights. He's already fought 5 times in this year, all of them in Panama. The last one was in September against Wilson Villasis.
Which was a good fight, actually.
Yes.
And that's a fighter that they both have in common. Coming into the ring, ready. Israel Lopez coming in with a record of 11 wins, 8 by knockout, 3 defeats, has only been stopped once, and 1 draw to Norberto Castro in December of 2022. He's already fought twice. As for Israel Lopez, this year, this will be his third.
Harvin Aguirre is called Puños de Acero. Let's go with Jeremiah Gallegos.
Ladies and gentlemen, boxing fans, live on Top Rank on ESPN Plus and ESPN Knockout from the Alexis Arguello Sports Complex in Managua, Nicaragua. Tonight, Tuto Zavala's All-Star Boxing delivers you the co-feature bout of the evening. Scheduled for 8 rounds in the welterweight division. Y ahora fanáticos en vivo por Top Rank on ESPN Plus y ESPN Knockout desde Polideportivo Alexis Arguello en Managua, Nicaragua. Tuto Zavala, All-Star Boxing, y entrega el combate coestelar. Este combate pactado a 8 asaltos en el peso welter. Sponsored by, patrocinado por Ox Agua Alcalina y Cervic. Los tres jueces, the 3 judges are de Nicaragua, César Berrios, Jancito Obregón, Silvio Ortiz, el referee, and your referee, Ramón González. Presentando primero en la esquina azul con los calzoncillos negro y blanco. Su peso oficial, 146.4 libras. Viene con un récord excelente. 16 combates, 11 victorias. 8 ganadas por la vía de knockout, 3 derrotas solo con un empate. Presenting first tonight, the fighter of the blue corner. Tonight he wears black with white. His official weight, 146.4 pounds. In 16 professional bouts, his record excellent. 11 victories, 8 huge wins by way of knockout, with 3 defeats and 1 draw. Presentando el ex titular, the former title holder, the pride of Tipitapa, Nicaragua, Israel Lopez. Y su oponente de la esquina roja, vestido con negro y blanco, entra con un peso oficial 146.4 libras. Su record oficial perfecto, 8 combates, 8 victorias, 6 victorias por la vía del knockout, sin derrotas. His rival fighting out of the red corner, wearing black with white. His official weight, 146.4 pounds. His professional record, perfect. 8 bouts, 8 victories, 6 wins coming to you by way of knockout. No defeats. Damas la bienvenida, el invicto de Nicaragua, vía de la ciudad de Panamá, Panamá, Harvin.
Ramon Gonzalez, the ref, gives him the instructions for this fight, and we are ready to go.
The history of both fighters is very peculiar. Both fighters wearing gags. And Israel Lopez, he works in the fields here in Nicaragua. He also works in pest control. Excellent by Harvin Aguirre, working the combinations.
As I said earlier, Harvin Aguirre very much takes his time, picks his punches, and then picks his opponents apart, little by little. He seems to be he fights like a very experienced fighter, although he only has 8 fights undefeated.
His jab is pretty fast by Harvin Aguirre.
Ooh, went right up, but he missed it, but it was so close. If he was able to land it, I'd say his opponent, Israel Lopez, would definitely be in trouble. He's a very good counter puncher. He loves to throw the body shot, especially that left to the body. This is actually one of the kids that I think that I'm very big on. I think that he has a bright future ahead of him if he's continuing to elevate his talent.
So far, he's undefeated in his career. 8 victories, 6 of those victories were by the way of knockout. 75% of his victories by knockout.
These are the big boys of tonight because they are in the welterweight division. Most of the fighters that came in tonight were 106, 105, and 112 pounds.
Yeah.
This one is a welterweight at 147 pounds. Oh, combination by Aguirre. Aguirre gets caught by a good body shot, but doesn't get fazed by it. Comes back in his own.
And excellent Lopez working the body for he's Harvin Aguirre.
Lopez and a lefty fighter, giving a little bit of trouble to Harvin Aguirre.
Harvin Aguirre, yeah, he was born here in Managua, but then moved to Panama. Smart fighter taking a step back and then just trying to get his better punches.
Aguirre did not like those body shots, that's for sure. He took a step back, he had to take a deep breath. Now he's moving around the ring, taking his time to get a shot once again, because he knows that Israel Lopez is dangerous.
Definitely, he's dangerous, yeah.
That's a body shot. Campesino, like you said, right? Yeah, he works the field. He works the field.
Oh, excellent! Right hook by Harvin Aguirre.
Israel Lopez comes right back. Although he was hurt and stunned from that shot, he came back with his own.
Right? And he's still hurt. Israel Lopez, that destroyer.
Harvin Aguirre walking around, taking his time once again. He sees that he's going to have to be a little bit more patient. He's not going to take out his opponent right away. Israel Lopez brave. Israel Lopez willing to take a shot to give a shot.
Excellent, Israel Lopez, one more time. And Harvin Aguirre connecting the better punches.
Both fighters want to prove themselves, finishing the round strong. Aguirre turns back, look back at his opponent in Lopez.
Here we go for the second round, bout scheduled for 8 on the welterweight division. Man, Harvin Aguirre, Jesse, throwing those big bombs, man. Trying to connect against Israel Lopez.
Harvin Aguirre has not gone the full 8 rounds. He only has fought once an 8 rounder, but he only fought to 4 rounds because he won by technical knockout. So this is the first fight that he may be going the full 8. Just due to the fact that Israel Lopez is a more experienced fighter. He's brave. Oh, what a hook. Nice right hook by Israel Lopez.
And there was a headbutt. An accidental headbutt.
Here we go, here we go. Guys got going.
Israel Lopez, he just walking forward.
Nice fighter shot to end that combination. By Harvin Aguirre. Harvin Aguirre looking for the shot, trying to find the opening.
And the way he moves up, sidesteps from Harvin Aguirre, very smart. A combination of 3 punches from Harvin Aguirre with no response from Israel Lopez.
Pushes the opponent down, wanting to calm him down, and he does. Referee steps in, breaks him up, and now we're in the exchanges again.
Ooh, right hand of the excellent one. Right hand here. Oh, now with the uppercut by Harvin Aguirre.
That was a clean, effective blow. And that's another one going on the attack. Sees him hurt. Good body shot right on the middle.
And you can tell that Israel Lopez, his legs are not with him all 100%.
Israel Lopez is definitely a little stunned. He's trying to come back with his own combination, but gets caught with a big right hand by Aguirre. Aguirre holds him again, which is illegal. He shouldn't be pushing his opponent down. But he doesn't want to get caught in the close distance, because that is where Israel Lopez makes the most damage.
But very smart having Aguirre.
Yeah, he looks like a veteran on
there. Yeah. Israel Lopez trying to work the body, trying to take some of his condition away.
Trying to show the younger Aguirre, I got some power in my tank as well, buddy.
Oh, excellent uppercut by Harvin Aguirre one more time. There's no defense on Israel Lopez, Jesse.
There is no defense. It's just pure bravery, pure guts, power, wild shots. But he has had some success in his career because of it. He walked away from that one. Saw it coming a mile away. Here you see the main event fighters coming in next, warming up. You have René Santiago from Puerto Rico at 5'3". Orthodox fighter from Urnacao, Puerto Rico.
El Chula Santiago,
Chulo Santiago coming in next.
Fighter in the main event against Kevin Vivas.
Here you see the replay where Israel Lopez came in trying to hit the body, made his opponent miss, but got caught with that uppercut and almost got connected with the hook as well. Pure guts, bravery from Israel Lopez.
Those uppercuts, man, they really hurt Israel Lopez.
What a right and an uppercut right down the middle. Don't forget you're talking about it, Carlos. Yeah. Nice hook as well. Yeah, all the replays from the action in that fight you see right now. Although Harvin Aguirre is a young fighter, he's fighting like an experienced one at that. Ready for the following round, coming into the third.
And one more time, just working with the jab from Harvin Aguirre, waiting for to get closer to work on the body.
Got the most uppercut hooks, letting his opponent come in, work the middle distance. Israel Lopez taking advantage of it. Any chance Israel Lopez gets, he lets his punches go in that mid-distance. That's his key. That's where he can be most effective.
Excellent right hand by Harvin Aguirre.
I mean, the blows that Harvin Aguirre has been able to land have been very impactful, and they've been very dangerous. If Lopez keeps taking his punches, who knows if he can withstand the full 8 rounds. Still early. It's only the 3rd round. This kid, Aguirre is strong, you can tell.
Oh, excellent by Israel Lopez. He's throwing those big punches, Israel Lopez.
Ooh,
there's the mouthpiece from Israel Lopez. He the referee.
Aguirre loading up right now. He's seen an opportunity to possibly take his opponent out. He's going for it. He's going for it. 2 shots, 3 shots. That was a push, shoved him down.
Knocked down. He's telling the referee, just put it in. Without washing it.
He just wants to fight. That's what it is. Once you're heated in there, you're ready to go. The referee separates him, say, all right, keep going now. Aguirre still attacking the body.
Oh, not for the head. See, body and head. Working the hooks up and down from Harvin Aguirre. Israel Lopez, Jesse, he only has one speed. He just moving forward all the time.
I mean, he's very limited. That's the issue with Lopez. As for Harvin Aguirre, he's able to be a little more multifunctional. He's able to move around, add different techniques to his arsenal. He can move around the ring, counter punch him. He can also attack him, fight him in the mid distance. He goes up to get the hook just as he did at this moment.
Oh, excellent. Now on the left hook by Israel Lopez.
Maybe a little more versatile. Trying to work at the distance right now. Headbutt between both.
Excellent.
Head movement by Aguirre.
Yeah. Okay. I think with Lopez just walking into the punches. Aguirre's with punches. But man, you can tell he has a lot of heart, huh?
I mean, look at his face, he's trying to slow it off, he's still moving forward, he's throwing some big shots. Ooh, it's just like that one there. But he does not stop. Pure guts. Moving forward. That's a wild shot.
This is Kevin Vivas.
Right.
Who's going to be in our main event. From Masaya, Nicaragua, undefeated so far in his career, 7-0 with 2 KOs. He was a silver medal in the Pan American Games in Nicaragua.
Young, only at 28 years of age, 7 wins, 2 knockouts. His knockout ratio isn't that high, so he must not be a big puncher, but he must have the style to really help him be victorious continuously. It's not easy going undefeated with 7 fights.
That's Ismael Alonso.
He also fought five times this last year already.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that's pretty.
Yeah.
That's him being very occupied. Normally it's 2 or 3 fights a year. This kid has taken 5 fights in 2022.
Harvin Aguirre.
come back in. Now we're going back to our fight. Andre Lopez against Harvin Aguirre. Harvin Aguirre has slowed down his tempo. I wonder if he's fatiguing. I think he's looking for another big shot. Going to set up his punches.
Oh, excellent right hook by Harvin Aguirre. And especially in this weight, Jesse is in 147 pounds. Walter weight.
And didn't know Aguirre. Trying to look for something. Trying to set up his opponent. And he lands that one too. What he was looking for. I think that Aguirre has realized that he's not going to be able to knock out his opponent. He's very open. He's very durable. So he's going to take his time, pick his punches, make sure he continues to win every round.
And he needs to get hit in the process. Right. He needs to continue working the body. You can tell Israel Lopez, he's feeling every time he's getting punched in the body.
Definitely, I think that's going to be a big factor for him. Because the older man, Aguirre Lopez, is definitely feeling the body shots, as you stated.
And especially because Israel Lopez, it's just, oh, excellent, that right hook by Israel Lopez. Just walking into Harvin Aguirre's punches.
And he's gaining more confidence right now. He sees that Aguirre doesn't want to engage. He wants to move around. So when Lopez goes into the attack and says, come here, young buck, and take some. And he actually landed with some good shots in front of him.
Yeah. Harvin Aguirre, 23 years of age, 30 years of age for Israel and Victoria Lopez.
Moving around, trying to find more to his opponent. Doesn't want it to work. Israel Lopez finds a way to continue working. Nice jab. By Lopez moving forward, looking for the shot. He's able to stay away from the straight right down the middle. Comes back with his own.
Yeah. No. Especially working the body from Israel Lopez también.
Big shot, big shot by Lopez.
The combination now from Harvin Aguirre.
We're back to banging, Ricardo. We're back to banging.
We can fight it up. Don't move these two guys.
Coming in, saying, I got some heat too, man. Here it is.
The thing with Israel Lopez is wide open. After he got his, that right hook.
Oh, good right.
Yeah.
Partially blocked, but still very effective.
You can tell the Israel Lopez is not 100%, Jesse.
He's not. He's tired. He's hurt.
Yeah.
He might have lost the equilibrium, mainly exhaustion.
We need to step back or just to try to hold because you can tell he's not 100% yet. Oh, one more time to the right hook.
The right hook over and over and over again landed by Aguirre.
One more time. And now Israel Lopez also connected his combination.
Lopez not afraid, not timid at all. Ready to get hit, but also ready to deliver his own big shots as well. They both may be a little fatigued in the fifth round. You can tell their body language says it all. Although, Aguirre is looking for that big right over the top.
Yeah.
Ooh, what a hook by Lopez. That was nicely done. Nice feint, and he came in with the hook. Held his opponent down. Tape's starting to fly off the glove once again.
Yeah, already the referee told the corner. I give the corner to get ready to tape.
The referee's going to have to jump in a bit. Put some more tape on that glove. What a hook. Lopez landed a great hook. That might have been the best shot of the fight. What do you think, Rick?
Definitely was the best. The best one by Israel Lopez.
Oh, yeah, right on the chin. It was right on the button. That's the thing. If a fighter gets cocky and he gets caught, that's when he may be put in trouble after winning the fight.
Last 15 seconds of this fifth round.
We thought that Aguirre might have taken out his opponent early in the round, but Lopez is able to come back with his own. Now he's in it again. And now they're exchanging.
This is one of the tougher rounds for the judges to score. I think having Aguirre is good enough for to take it.
There's a replay coming in. Right hand over the top that hurt Lopez. Aguirre goes on the attack as soon as the opponent stumbles. His opponent, Lopez, runs around the ring, trying not to get hit because he knows that he's hurt. And Aguirre trying to finish him, landing some good shots. Left, right, but fortunately for Lopez, he was able to recover just in time. This is the shot once again. Landed at will. Lopez came back with his own. That was the hook.
That was the right hook.
That was the right hook that really made an impact. Helps him come back in this fight. What a shot. That was the best punch of the night coming in from Israel Lopez.
Israel Lopez, definitely.
Right on the button, right on the chin. I'm surprised that Aguirre didn't go down from that shot.
We're going to the sixth round. Not scheduled for eight. In the welterweight division, Israel Lopez, a black trunk with white trimming. And Harvin Aguirre. With a leopard. Animal.
Aguirre still trying to look for the same shot. The right over the top. Still controlling the distance.
And Israel Lopez just waiting, trying to connect his on the counter.
And he's trying to recover a little bit right now.
Yeah.
He may be a little fatigued. I mean, you see it from time to time again in this fight that they'll get a little winded. They need some time to come back a little more efficiently, a little more active, and then once they find that right moment, they come back with some big shots. And that's exactly what both are doing right now.
Yeah, Harvin Aguirre, he doesn't want to be a static target. So constantly moving to the sides.
Harvin Aguirre getting a lot of experience in this fight. Israel Lopez is definitely putting him to the test. How much does he want it? He's definitely asking himself that question right now. And then the referee tells him.
Yeah, I'm almost at this. The referee told Harvin Aguirre.
Aguirre picking the shots at a distance.
Israel Lopez, they need to throw a little more combinations, just throwing the jabs. Sporadically.
But I agree with you. Should throw more punches because not winning this fight In my point of view, I think Aguirre is up on points.
I agree.
He's one of the most effective players. Seems to be in control. Although, Israel Lopez is a little dangerous. Not a little dangerous, very dangerous.
Very dangerous, right?
Yeah. Ooh, nice job.
Very good job.
I'm going to need to change it up a little bit. He's getting the speed again. Ooh, got a counter punch by Aguirre. Aguirre starting to keep control once again.
One more time, that right hook by Harvin Aguirre.
And Lopez says that does not do anything to me. Does not sign. Aguirre tired himself. Ooh, what a shot. Good left. Good left by Lopez. Moving forward still. Aguirre walking around.
But definitely, Lopez didn't throw that many punches in this round. He was taking a breather.
Breather. 10 seconds left. This round is up for the taking. Let's see who finishes stronger. Ooh, good hook by Lopez. The hook was definitely very impactful for the judges. Yeah, Aguirre landing his punches.
You can tell how Harvin Aguirre was just waiting for Israel Lopez to step in so he could connect his best punches.
Yeah, I think he was trying to play it safe at this point. He might be feeling the punches from his opponent. Here you have the brothers, Alvarado.
Yeah.
Twin brothers, which you know well. You've commentated some of their fights.
Felix Alvarado, yeah. Los Gemelos. They were both champions at one time.
Former world champions. Yeah. Big.
And Israel Lopez throwing everything in this seventh round.
Doesn't have much time left, so he definitely has to give it all he has. Not winning this fight so far. He has to change it up. These two rounds are going to be very important for him. Does a good job of it. Last two punches.
No.
Ooh, right hand over the top. Right over the hand.
Good job. It's Ryan Lopez. And then Harvin Aguirre just a constant movement.
Keeping in control. That's what he's doing. He should be doing a little more. I think he could do a lot more, actually. But he doesn't want to risk it.
Well, if he just being smart, Jesse, and I think he's getting a very smart fight.
That's true. He sees that he's winning the fight by taking the risk.
Correct. Yeah. Plus, he connects his punches and then just move.
Ooh, nice job. Oh, good counter, right? Yeah, get it. Everybody chanting Harvin. They want him to finish strong. Counter punch.
Nice fight, Aguirre.
Lopez corner says, get him up, hit him down.
Yeah, they want him to wear the body.
He definitely has to attack. Lopez has to attack a lot more if he wants to come out victorious. This round is going strong for Aguirre. Lopez corner screams out, pressure him.
That's Joshua Alonso. Right hook. Excellent, the right hook by Lopez, eh?
Well, they did say pressure him. The minute he pressured him, it worked for him. But the question is, can he maintain that pressure? Ooh, what a 1-2. That was nice. Right down the middle. Okay, Aguirre doesn't like that shot. Nicely done by Lopez. Lopez goes on the attack once again. Moving forward. Jab, as you stated, Rick, he has to do more than just throw a jab right now.
Definitely.
Nice counter. I get it. Good combination. Aguirre raises his hands for a second, showing the confidence that he's winning the fight. Walking the ring, 10 seconds to go. Raising his hands. It's not the last round yet, though.
It's not the last round, exactly.
Oh, what a hook.
It was seven rounds, not the eight. He won the fight. Hey, one more.
Yeah, he got up on the corner.
Yeah.
His corner says, hey, what are you doing? There's still one more to go.
One more to go.
Yeah, I've never seen that before. Oh, that was a good combination. Good hook right hand by Aguirre. And this is Yossi Lopez continuing to apply pressure, looking for the victory, looking for himself to land some good punches. I mean, he's trying. He definitely has the intentions to win. Well, that was actually a good hook by Lopez. That's when they shot it to him, put the pressure on him, and it worked. Those were the shots, straight left, right down the middle. I mean, if he continues with the pressure and energy, he can be successful, but right now it may be a little too late in this fight.
Yeah. Let's see if Harvin Aguirre has some gas on the tank for the last 3 minutes. For the eighth and last round.
Lopez going on the attack, landing some big blows. He knows he needs this round desperately.
Yeah.
And he does. Coming in with shots, heavy shots. Aguirre comes back with his own.
Aguirre is working the combinations excellent. To the body, to the head from Israel Lopez.
Lopez has that killer view right now, killer eyesight. He wants to go for it. He's looking for the big shots to knock out his opponent. He knows he needs it.
And he knows he needs it, yeah. That was very smart from Harvin Aguirre to just hold.
Lopez corner screams, again. A desperately need the knockout win. His corner says, for your son, for your children, for your children. What a body shot by Aguirre. Aguirre still landing more body blows.
And you can see it in his Israel Lopez's face that he failed that one.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, one more time combination by Harvin Aguirre.
Aguirre seems to be comfortable.
No. Oh, what was that from Israel Lopez?
Lopez pushed him down, hit him in the back. Illegal blow.
Yeah.
Referee warns Lopez. That happens again. The referee can take a point away.
You can see there's some desperation in Israel Lopez.
He is. Yes. He's frustrated. You can tell it. He doesn't know how to come out victorious.
Right.
Apparently, the knockout isn't going to come because as many punches as he landed, Aguirre was able to take it. Aguirre can take a punch.
Even if he wins this round, I don't think he'll win the fight.
I agree with you, Ricardo.
Combination from Harvin Aguirre.
Less than a minute to go. Harvin Aguirre trying to set up a big shot. Trying to set up the right hand. Didn't let it go. But then he lands it right now. That same shot that he was looking for.
Right.
Landed right down the middle.
But he's very patient. He's waiting. Oh, what excellent left hook by Harvin Aguirre. But you can tell that Israel Lopez, my dear Jesse, man, he has a lot of guts, man.
The guts, the grit, the bravery from Lopez. He knows he's down, but he's still trying to entertain the fans. He's still trying to land his own punches. Not making much of a difference there.
Correct.
Right. Still seems to be up on the scorecards.
Last 10 seconds of this fight. That's it. We're going to have to go to the judges to find out who's the winner of this fight. Remember that
coming on the boxing calendar for ESPN tomorrow. Tyson Fury versus Francis Ngannou on ESPN pay-per-view, live from Saudi Arabia.
That's going to be a good one. I'm really looking forward to that one.
Yeah,
Tyson Fury, yeah, man, against Ngannou. That's bringing in so much revenue. I'm surprised that it's in Saudi Arabia, because normally fights like that are held in Las Vegas. But the Saudis are investing money,
a lot of money in boxing, right?
Yeah. Big money in this new city that they have building over there. It's going to be like another Dubai.
Chocolatito Gonzalez
in the house. Chocolatito Gonzalez, former unified champion, WBC champion. He is one of the special ones in this sport.
At one time, he was the pound for pound, the best.
He was. He recently lost his title to Estrada. And Gallito Estrada, what a fight they put down, though. Three fights that were memorable. Three fights that were memorable. Chocolatito Gonzalez against El Gallo Estrada. We're going back to the Tyson Fury fight. As we go, here it is, Chocolatito Gonzalez. People love him here. Everywhere he goes. 20 weeks, the ref right next to him. Referee is well known all around boxing world. The twins, Los Gemelos. You're here once again. Tons of support in Nicaragua for these fighters. Big superstars in the area. Tutiquin, Zavala. Chiquita Gonzalez in the back, one of the best in his division, his era. The very first fighters in his smaller divisions to win over $1 million. Credit to him. Chocolatito Gonzalez. The fans here, they greet him. We go back to the scores, and we're passing it over
to Jeremiah Gallegos.
Damas y caballeros, un gran aplauso para estos dos guerreros aquí adentro del ring. Después de 8 asaltos, increíble de este combate, vamos a las tarjetas de los jueces. Ladies and gentlemen, after 8 incredible rounds, we now go to the judges' scorecards. Juez Silvio Ortiz lo ve este combate 78-74. César Berrios lo ve este combate 78-74. Y juez Jacinto Obregón lo tiene 76-76. Our judges here have this contest. Silvio Ortiz 78-74. Judge Obregón has it 76-76. And Cesar Berrios has it 78-74 to the winner by majority decision. El invicto, Harvin Money Man Aguirre.
Aguirre by majority decision. Two of the judges, Cesar Barrios and Silvio Ortiz, had it 78-74, while Jacinto Obregón had it tied 76-76.
I don't know, man. I don't know how you can put that fight as a tie.
I agree.
Definitely not. I disagree completely. Credit to all the judges, but that was not ever possible. Don't know how that happened. I don't criticize the judges, but no.
I do. I'm a judge.